my wife and I are thinking about getting a dog together. And I wanted to get your guys' opinion. What should we do? Should we go to a breeder or should we adopt? Breeder. Thank you for agreeing with me. This is going to sound fucked up coming from a Jewish couple, but we just really want something with a superior, pure bloodline. And I've had people get really mad at me. I heard some of you shout out adopt. I've had people get in my face and say, if you don't adopt a dog, a shelter is going to kill them. And I said, holy shit. We should be mad at the shelter then. How am I the bad guy? Instead of this business operating solely on threats. That'd be like if a gun store said, for every firearm we don't sell, we're gonna donate to a bullied kid with a bowl cut and a list of names. Your move! And if you guys are worried, please don't be. I lied to you. We actually already got a dog and we adopted it from a shelter. We're heroes. I only lied to you to prove a point, and my point is this. I am genuinely touched to see that people are so passionate about adopting puppies. But how come we never see people as passionate about adopting people? How come you never go to a gender reveal party and see a guy scream at a pregnant lady, breeding? No. Need to get a shelter human. Rescue a baby, bitch. And for dogs, there's all these cute expressions. You've all heard this one, adopt, don't shop. But how come you never hear, quit porking, grab an orphan? Where's that bumper sticker? Quit porking, grab an orphan. And the reason I'm so pro-adoption is because my little cousin that I grew up with was adopted, and I wish there wasn't such a stigma attached to it. Because he didn't find out till he was 12 years old, and it devastated him. He felt like he was lied to, and he, to this day, does not call my aunt and uncle mom and dad anymore. He only calls them Mike and Rita, which is fucked up. Because their names are Steve and Judy. Stigma did something to his little noggin. And listen, if we have some parents here tonight or some prospective parents and you have or you want to have one or two biological kids of your own, I get it. Adoption is a long, complicated, expensive procedure, and fucking without a condom is just swell, gang. But I will never understand these couples that say, oh, we have 8 kids, 7 boys, 1 girl. We just kept trying for the girl. Yo, you don't have a conception problem. You have a gambling problem. If you want a girl so bad, stop playing the slots and go to the claw grab. If you really wanted a girl so bad, during China's one-child policy, there were thousands of Chinese girls in need of a good home. You could have adopted a Chinese girl, then one day you would have wound up with a Jewish son-in-law. That is a good investment. Some of you Gentiles look confused. Don't worry. I am happy to explain that punchline. Stereotypically, Jews love Asian women. That's one of our lesser known stereotypes. It's over in the hidden files, right alongside the fact that we're all lactose intolerant. And the reason we don't eat bacon is because it makes our foreskin grow back. So now, aww. You came for comedy and you're leaving culturally enriched. Speaking of foreskin, one great reason to adopt, and especially adopt an older child, is you to avoid awkward decisions, like circumcision, for example. One of my best friends, he's Jewish. He married a British woman. Jews, we always circumcise. Brits, they never circumcise. I know, I thought just their teeth were gross. Any hoozles. My friend and his wife had a son and suddenly found themselves in quite the little pickle over the little pickle because both sets of parents were real opinionated about what they should do. It's barbaric. You can't. It's tradition. You must. And it's not like my friend could have said, "Don't worry, we compromised. Ollie will be circumcised halfway." It looks like his wiener popped its collar. It looks like the top of Count Dracula's cape. It looks like that spitting dinosaur from Jurassic Park. It looks like it's wearing an airplane neck pillow. It looks like an albino half-shelled pistachio. It looks like... Am I losing some of you on this? If you're not comfortable thinking about baby dick this long and this hard, and you're planning on being a parent, then you fucking better quit porking and grab an orphan. What a wholesome ending to that horrible joke.